Hello guys, welcome to another episode of Crossout. Today I'm building you a new build, which is good in any occasions and includes two deploy drones and two explosive spears. Now this build is very tactical. Some of you people, I hope you like it. So this build includes two large tires at the back to push forward to speed. Mostly the ones that turn in directions, not the ones that are stable, which will give you more of an attack manual. Then you can have two spiked wheels or just a bunch of small wheels, regular common wheels. And then for your build, you want to put down a Vivern cabin. Sorry, it's hard to read it. Which is an airplane cabin, which will give you 5 spaces in front and 3 spaces at the back. That's how you want to place it out. For the back, you want to put down a powerful engine sideways, about like this. It doesn't matter how, but it needs to be standing like that. In a 3x4 on the sides and 4 like that, about 2 wide. I hope this explains to you how exactly you want to put it down. Otherwise, you want two deploy turns with one of them facing arrows that way and the other facing the arrows the opposite, which will be like that. Then you want two large pipes, these bad boys, the long pipe shield, I guess what those they call them, but these are regular pipes, I guess you can't call them shields. Otherwise you want two plows, one at the bottom like that and one at the top, which will make a mouth like that. If you have large ones, which I don't, you put them instead, which will give you more protection. You'll be have a more of a needle like attack motion, which is very active and dangerous for other enemies, which will be perfect. Then you want the biggest kind of metal boards on the sides, which are called container walls. You want this kind of container walls on both sides, and then you want tiny quarter parts of the wall, which you will put on the bottom, starting from the pipes and all the way across. Do this on both sides. Doing this, you get this done, which makes a very beautiful looking kind of vehicle, which honestly I like to see. But then before anything else, you want to add in another engine. And then for the front, you want to add the two spears, which conclude, you can either put it like that or on the bottom piece right there. Like, see, I did it right here, but otherwise this is, I guess, much decenter because you don't have on one piece, you have on a huge piece and a piece. So yeah, do it like that, not the other way. Otherwise you want to put on one tiny T-pipe, which is really an extension for you to put on the other regular pipes. The ones can only be put on one way. So like this, you have exact perfect protection all the way across, which will protect these two pipes. And maybe if a cannon hits this first, this pipe will still be standing, which is a very tactical, I personally think. Otherwise, this is it. But if you guys are the ones that think the swoops are amazing, you can put one like this, the other on the bottom. Then you can take it again, do that. That makes a beautiful looking part of the vehicle. Then you still, to be honest, we do have more of these. if you want to be extra tactical, you can do this, which now is even better than before. You can set them up like that. Same thing to this side. Now you have a very good old defensive maneuver. So that's it. And that. So now this vehicle is 100% protected. All we have to do now is to test it. So this vehicle, what of armoring. So first I'm gonna go full speed. Decent speed, as you guys can see. Good maneuvering. So right there, that was a fail by me, but it did take out two big tracks. And if you are going full speed, you can just drop off those units and go get away. As you can see, they do a lot of damage. If you do 100 more damage per shot, that is done if you're doing it per second. Otherwise, let's get into a few battles and show off this build. So I haven't showed you any kind of raids or brawls because brawls are hard to get into. Raids are not, but I will build a build that will be good enough for raids. Otherwise, for now, we're doing get the machine gun, which isn't going well already. Pretty sad, but otherwise, while I'm waiting, I'm just gonna show this off again. So here's an enemy. You can approach him all the way, then you can just cancel it and get away. Like that, we should drop off the units. I didn't mean to ram the enemy, but you drop off the drones and you get away and you got it done. But anyways, you are in a low, you're under 400 PS, which will keep you against not strong but easy enemies. Which then you can fight off and get a lot of points with. Yeah, you want to play tactical, you're not a unit that can attack well. Then it looks like we have somebody approaching right here. I don't think the drones will be able to get them. So we'll just ram them. I guess bring them down. Great. This guy really took off my frontal armor. Yeah, I hate them bitches. Sorry guys for the language, but these bastards are very annoying. The wasp launchers. See the guy, all he can do is have we attempt to do that. Now, since you're so good, there we go. He's getting shot up. He's about to die. Perfect. Yep, that's how you kill a person. And look at that. We only lost two small wheels. Pretty well done. Okay, David's about to die. He has no guns, and it looks like it's our first victory. It's well done. Let's drop. Oh, well, there you go. So this thing survived the most powerful normal weapons. Two wasp launchers that shoot two rockets each, which one of them equals to almost as much of damage as a regular cannon shot. So you really got shot by four cannon shots and you survived. My frontal armor did an amazing job against that, survived both hits, and the drone packages were still sitting there. But about the spears, you want to focus on enemies where you know their generators are, which will do massive damage and one-shot the enemy. That's your main kind of act. Anyways, if soaked armor worked in this game, you would have had a lot of bullet ricochets. At the side pipes, looks like this, as you saw, did protect the first wave of wasps against the main piece of armor, but then it took out the back. But when a guy shot me in the ass, it did take out my back armor, which kept my engines alive. Which engines are the most key part of the weapon in this vehicle. So, it's like we got somebody on the cap already. There we go. That guy's getting shot up. They're shooting up people. I don't have to do anything. Whoever's out there is gonna take a lot of damage. Now this guy. We can just sing some ring around the rosies here. There we go, that guy's dead. And now we're gonna finish that guy off. We lose one of our big wheels. Looks like our turns are still firing. Okay, now that's not fun. I have an AI that is just attempting to kill me. I hate him a lot. The vehicle's still maneuverable. Oh, no. Let's try to place these turrets right here. Please. Oh, there we go. Oh, wow. Nobody attacked the main guy. Well, that wasn't fun. Anyways, I should be able to play off another battle, and then I'll be over with. Anyways, here's the last battle. So let's boogie. So we're approaching in the Founders Canyon. Best attack points, the enemy's going from the other side, which isn't good. So I'll drop off turrets, which will do damage to them and kill them. Or just give me a kill assist. Looks like I got another guy back there. My turrets will do damage too. I'm gonna see if I can ram the enemy. Ooh, well. Better get away. That was sweet. So the wheels, as you can see, do show off a good enough of power. Let's continue though. I should be able to get back on him. Here's two guns. Let's do this. The enemy's been triggered. The turns are firing. We got him down. So, looks like we lost one of our great wheels. Florence is down here. Oh, we did it. Well, here's another vehicle that you guys can use. This time I'm showing you a build of it. I hope you guys enjoyed the episode and have a good time. Please leave a like and subscribe too. Goodbye.